There's a guy who wants to take my fucking bench right now.
So let's go. Then just start talking.
Hey, guys, we're training shoulders today. Let's go. My coach, and he upped my cardio to 7 days a week, fasted in the morning, 45 minutes, so.
I don't hear a bitch, she was bitching last week. I'm still only 5 sessions of cardio, what's Matt doing? Just follow the plan, bitch. Yeah. Now you've been up to 7, now you're bitching.
Let the fun begin with hubby. Boy, if you a bowler, then you know me. Girl, if you a stunner, then you know me. I'm living that life of a young OG. And everybody doing that, see me doing that. Boy, if you a grinder, then you know me. Girl, if you a stunner, then you know me. I'm living that life of a young OG. And everybody doing that, see me doing that. Fuck me, right? Fuck me. Right now, I need my coach. Where's my coach? He's insta-famous, apparently, right now. I'm so fly, staring at the hard top as I ride by. Got money to the sky, cause my lifestyle true. Been doing it for years, but my lifestyle new.
It's about 97 degrees and 89% humidity in this place right now. I'm not complaining. Our life is great. God bless those people in Texas right now that are dealing with all the struggles.
Yeah, don't complain about the fucking weather here. The weather is absolutely perfect.
I'm just a big baby and I can't handle the heat. That's why I don't live in Miami.
This is a conversation, guys, that you should have with your significant others when you meet. Where do you want to retire? Where do you want to raise kids? Where do you eventually want to live? Because I want to live in Vegas, Miami, or here, and Brad wants to live where there's no people, like
Alaska
or back where he's from.
Iceland.
In New Hampshire.
And what a warm-up set is.
Oh, so those other two were not working sets.
They were warm-up.
Got it. I apparently was not working. I thought I was working. So apparently by the time we get to the 50-pound dumbbells and I'm completely pooped is when we're actually starting the workout. Usually when I'm by myself, because I don't have a spotter, 50-pound dumbbells, that's pretty much where I'm done and we're just getting started.
DC style training, you literally only do 2, maybe 3 true working sets your entire workout, that's it. You pick 2 or 3 exercises and you only have 1 balls out working set at the end, and that's only count as your working set.
Once I pass 45 pound dumbbells, I start adding things to every set. So some of you may not know the struggles of what it's like when you turn 30. I have to put on like sleeves and wrist things and belts and all sorts of things just to get through a workout because I don't want to injure myself really. But nothing compares to the amount of stuff that Brad puts on. So Brad actually wears a mouthpiece while he's training because he clenches his jaw so tight that he actually has chipped his front tooth multiple times. He's on the first name basis with our dentist now. 160? Are you high? I like my fucking hand was about to let go. No, you're slippery.
So then I'll get you grips.
Now I need other grips. Now we need to add one more thing. So in the last episode, I talked about how special Gold's Gym is. I've gone through my ups and downs at Gold's Gym, and reason being that when you step off stage, some people tend to rebound a little bit. I stepped off stage at 134 and I went up to 164 at my heaviest. So naturally, people are gonna ask, hey, are you competing anymore? Are you moving up a division? I literally had people asking me, how much do you weigh now? All that did was fill me with anxiety. I was in the parking lot every day at Gold's Gym debating if I was gonna go inside or not. And it got so bad to the point that I decided, you know what, I don't wanna train here anymore. And I took about 5 months off from Gold's just so that I could feel like I could get my training in and not have to explain to people why I wasn't stepping on stage or why I had gained weight. It was a really dark time in my life. It affected my relationship with my husband. It affected my work and my mental state, really. I mean, everything leading up to that point, which was my heaviest in January, was kind of a whirlwind of emotion where I didn't know where to channel it. So I decided to train out of LA Fitness for a little while just to get my bearings down and refocus on what my plans were if I even wanted to compete anymore. So if you're feeling like this, you're not alone. There's always different avenues that you can take. I joined CrossFit, and it was just to change up the monotony of going to the gym and training like a bodybuilder, and it made working out fun again for me. And I didn't feel the pressure anymore. I also changed my eating habits where it wasn't like a strict diet regimen where I was counting calories. I ate when I was hungry and I decided to go keto. So I did little things step by step just to feel normal again, I guess. But just know that you guys aren't alone if you're feeling like this. Find ways to channel that anxiety to a more positive thing and maybe change your atmosphere, and that helped for me.
Oh, he's not trying to kiss me?
She never kisses me. Good morning, good night, nothing. She bartends at night, like last night. I woke up when she came in the room. I rolled over, I was like, hi baby, how are you? No response.
Oh my hello? God, that is not so, what
yes.
he said.
So I go, hello, how was your night? So I was pissed off, she didn't acknowledge me. Oh, my night was so shitty.
That is not at all how the story went. I walked into the bedroom and all he said was, hello? As if he didn't know it was me coming into the room, and it startled me. He was basically sitting up in a dark room, so he scared the shit out of me.
I just totally made this up.
Yeah, it's useless. Let's do something else.
It hits front delts. It's not you, it's useless. I felt it, it felt good.
Let's just get dumbbells and do the double dumbbells.
My way always sucks, I don't know what I'm doing.
So he's not completely wrong about that. I tend to like my workouts the way they are. Brad's the only person that I fight with when I train. I've had other trainers in the past and I just do what I'm told. But for some reason, when you're training with your husband, you feel like you can kind of, I guess, talk back.
Play that game. Upright, up, upright.
I feel like I'm not shrugging.
You are. I'm telling you, watch your body.
You told me to take a step back.
To not hit this thing.
Right, so then why didn't you just grab it and then tell me step back in?
Let's go. Thank you. I believe I'm the trainer, right? Okay.
Did I ever fight with you? I didn't fucking fight with you. You liar. No, I didn't.
Like
I did
said,
not.
Every single thing I tell her to do, I'm wrong. That's not how she likes to do it.
So I'm apparently the most difficult person to train on the planet. Chris is a liar, by the way. I've trained with Chris a couple of times, and you guys can even see the footage. We shot with him. There was no fighting involved, but they're making me seem like the bad guy here. It's only with Brad that I fight with while training.
I cannot believe this, guys. They're both turning against me right now.
No, you're speaking the truth. Drive back with a vengeance.
What?
Drive back with a vengeance. Put some fucking oomph in it.
Drive back with a vengeance. My husband is the cheesiest person I know.
What the fuck is this shit? How can you train when someone has fucking 15 different sets of dumbbells? at least I have the respect when I do drop sets and things like that, I just leave it in the rack. If I go to get something and it's not there, guess what? I either move up or move down 5 pounds and make it work, because we fucking share.
So we let a couple sets go by, and I could see my husband just getting more angry and more angry. So as I walked by to pick up my weights, I just grabbed this other person's weights and I started to be racking them. And I told him nicely when he said to me, I'm using those weights. I said, okay, well, can you just move them out of the way? And Brad kind of snapped at him a little bit.
Yo. Fees, what up? Yeah. Hello there, I thought to myself. When she walked past, could she be here by herself? Should I ask, or should I stay to myself? I'd probably just play it safe and not say shit else. But I've been that guy for too long, and this drink that I got is kinda strong. Plus it's my song, I'm going in for it, bro. Turns out she was really all with it from the go. Lights dim, music low, kinda slow. I think I might pull her Operation Repo. Limo, we float, I bet you I can make her body explode. T4, we go on, and y'all with it and we know. Ayo, taxi man, Hotel Nico. San Francisco, elevated out of reach though. We medicated in a cloud of sour diesel. She say she down till we gone. And these fast.
Officially 10 weeks out from my show. Calories have been dropped and the cardio has been up. But I'm feeling great where I'm at right now. This is probably the best I've looked this far out from my show. But that being said though, guys, I probably won't be at the Olympia this year just because I have to focus on my prep and taking care of the puppies because we have 3 dogs. But Brad will be there. He has some photo shoots lined up and some exciting things coming up for him. So I'm really excited to share that with you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in today and I'll see you next time.
Once again, I am in the same predicament. On and off battle stations, fighting once again. Trying to ask how this is the life will end. I need to take off, fire up the engines.